गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई एम कार्तिकेय मनोज सक्सेना। आई एम हेयर टू डिस्कस टॉपिक दैट इज जुडिशियल सेपरेशन, सेक्शन 10 ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट 1955। दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ मैरिटल रेमेडी इन हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट। नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट इन डिटेल्स। इमेजिन अ हस्बैंड एंड वाइफ विच कैन नॉट लिव टुगेदर एंड दे वॉन्ट टू फाइल अ डिवोर्स। अ डिवोर्स कैन बी फाइल्ड ऑन द ग्राउंड्स ऑफ सेक्शन 13(1) एंड 13(2). नाउ वॉट आर सेक्शन 13(1) एंड 13(2)? 13(1) आर द रीजन सम रीजन्स फॉर डिवोर्स फॉर बोथ हजबेंड एंड वाइफ, वेयर आज 13(2) आर द रीजन आर अवेलेबल फॉर ओनली वाइफ। 13(2) टॉक्स अबाउट दैट ओनली देर आर सम ग्राउंड्स दैट ओनली दैट ग्राउंड्स विल बी टेकन बाय वाइफ at the time of divorce, and all these reasons are can be the reason of judicial separation. Judicial separation can be applied by husband as well as by wife or by both, and in some cases of divorce the judge give a judicial separation, and judge says that try to live once again, if you are failed then you can come for a divorce. Court gave a chance of to both husband and wife that try to come together again and do not file a divorce. If they try and then try went wrong, then they can go for a again divorce in a court. So judicial separation is basically staying away from each other as order of the court. Court gave order just in a favor that the divorce will not happen and the both husband and wife live happily. And if it is not possible for husband and wife to live happily, then they can again go to court for a divorce, and then the court will give the divorce on the grounds of section 13(1) and section 13(2), whether 13(1) is available for husband and wife and 13(2) is available for the female. That's only for wife. If a husband and wife staying away from each other without the notice of court, then it is not a judicial separation, it is a conjugal restitution of conjugal rights. In restitution of conjugal rights, the courts bring that husband and wife together, where in judicial separation, court says that you live alone and try to resolve your marriage and don't try for a divorce. Now let us understand what are the ground for divorce for both husband and wife. Well, section 31A talks about the grounds available for both, whether there is a adultery, cruelty, desertion, conversion, unsoundness of mind, venereal disease, renification of world, or premeduce to death. Adultery is something that having intimacy with another male or a female. Cruelty is something that beating someone, or conversion is something that dharam parivartan hona, it's called conversion. Unsoundness of mind means you are incapable of understanding anything for a lifetime. Venereal disease, any kind of hazardous disease, and renication of the world like sadhu sant panjana. And presumed death is something when you are unknown for at least 2 years, that where is your wife you don't know, and that where is your husband you don't know, then this is presumed death. And grounds available for wife alone, that is section 13(2). It is bigamy, rape, portion of puberty. That's it. Thank you. Now let us understand what are the ground for divorce for both husband and wife. Well, section 31A talks about the grounds available for both, whether there is a adultery, cruelty, desertion, conversion, unsoundness of mind, venereal disease, renification of world, or premeduce to death. Adultery is something that having intimacy with another male or a female. Cruelty is something that beating someone, or conversion is something that dharam parivartan hona, it's called conversion. Unsoundness of mind means you are incapable of understanding anything for a lifetime. when a real disease, any disease, any kind of hazardous disease, and reneging of the world, like Sadhu Sant Panjana, and presume that presume that is something when you are unknown for at least 2 years, that where is your wife you don't know, and that where is your husband you don't know, then this is presumed death. And grounds available for wife alone, that is section 13(2). It is bigamy, rape. At last, we will discuss about the judicial separation, difference between judicial separation and divorce. In judicial separation, marriage is still alive, where in divorce there is an end of relationship. In judicial separation, legally allowed to stay separate but can't marry. If marry bigamy, punishment specified in section 17, legally allowed to marry another male or female. This is in judicial separation. This is an opportunity to see the possibility that the both will come together and stay and live happy life. If they'll not happen, then the court give you a divorce. In divorce, this is a final verdict to separate. Well, in short, judicial separation is a separation given by a court to live alone far away, but you can try to come back in relationship. Well, in divorce, there is the end of whole relationship. Thank you.